praise thy name. Lord of all, we bow before thee. All on earth thy scepter own. All in heaven above adore thee. Infinite thy vast domain. All my trust I place in thee. Never, Lord, abandon me. Hark with loud and pealing hymn. Thee the angel choirs are praising. Cherubim and seraphim, one unceasing chorus raising, ever sing with sweet accord. Holy, holy, holy Lord. Holy, holy, holy Lord.
This Mass is offered for the soul of Ammani Kochappan, offered by Lalu Rani Arikot and family. For the soul of Annam Kutti Paulos, offered by Lalu Rani Arikot family. For the soul of Anthony Chinnappa and Elizabeth Mary, offered by family. For the good health of Emilda Mary, offered by Dominic Arpita. For the soul of Petronius Silveira by Bennett family. For the soul of A.I. Nathan, Lourdes Mary by Maria family. Thanksgiving by Rajendra family. Thanksgiving by Stella Furtado. For the intention by Norbert Furtado and family. For the soul of Jenny Joseph by family members. For the soul of Arul Mary, offered by Father Arun. Thanksgiving by Ravi on his birthday, offered by Father Arun. And for the souls in the family of Sundar Raj. For the soul of Agapitas by Tangamma. For the soul of Lawrence Sushila Chaku, offered by Terence and family. Thanksgiving by Fabian. And thanksgiving by Bindu Joseph and family. And also for the intentions of the English Legion of Mary. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the 23rd Sunday in the ordinary times. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading from the book of Ezekiel 33, verses 7 to 9. If you do not speak to warn the wicked to turn from his way, his blood I will require at your hand. A reading from the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you, son of man, I have made a watchman for the house of Israel. Whenever you hear a word from my mouth, you shall give them warning from me. If I say to the wicked, O wicked one, you shall surely die, and you do not speak to warn the wicked to turn from his way, that wicked person shall die in his iniquity, but his blood I will require at your hand. But if you warn the wicked to turn from his way, and he does not turn from his way, that person shall die in his iniquity, but you will have delivered your soul. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice. Harden not your hearts.
Oh, that today
you would listen to his voice. Harden not your hearts. Come, let us ring out our joy to the Lord. Hail the rock who saves us. Let us come into his presence giving thanks. Let us hail him with a song of praise. Response, oh, that you
listen to his
listen
voice,
to his voice, harden not your hearts. Oh, come, let us bow and bend low. Let us kneel before the God who made us. For he is our God, and we the people who belong to his pasture, the flock that is led by his hand. Response, oh, that today you would listen to his voice, harden not your hearts. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice, harden not your hearts, as at Meribah, as on that day at Masha in the desert, when your forebears put me to the test, when they tried me, though they saw my work. Response, oh, that today you would listen to his voice, harden not your hearts. The second reading, love is the fulfilling of the law. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, woe no one anything except to love each other. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. For the commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and any other commandment are summed up in this word, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does not wrong to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In Christ, God was reconciling the world to Himself and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "If your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have gained your brother. But if he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, that every charge may be established by the evidence of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church. And if he refuses to listen even to the church, let him be to you as a Gentile and a tax collector. Truly I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything they ask, it will be done for them by my Father in heaven. For where two or three are gathered in my name, there am I among them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brethren in Christ Jesus, in spite of COVID-19, we have a great reason to be happy and peaceful in our lives. Today we have a beautiful text from the Gospel of Matthew. If your brother sins against you, talk to him, tell him his fault, where you and him alone. If he doesn't listen to you, then take two or three with you. And if he refuses to listen to them, then take him to the church. If he refuses to listen to the church, then treat him as a tax collector, as a Gentile. And Jesus continually says, where two are gathered, agreed on earth for a particular reason, for what they pray, it will be granted by my Heavenly Father. And he again says, where two or three are gathered in my name, I will be with them. My presence will be with them. Dear brothers and sisters, now let me ask a question. What do you want in your life? You have a family, you have a beautiful house to stay, and you have different kinds of food to eat. You may go to best hospital when you feel sick, and your children may study in international school, and you may have security of life. Now, let me ask the same question. What do you want in your life? If we ask this question to the poor people and middle class people, they may say, we want all these luxuries in our life. Whereas, if we ask this question to the richest people in India or in the world, they may say, we want happiness, a true happiness in our life. They have home, they have food, they have shelter, they have everything, and they have a security of life. In spite of that, they want true happiness in their life, because the material things cannot give us a true happiness. Only inner peace can give us a true happiness. That's what the reading speaks about. So, in today's Gospel, Jesus speaks about inner peace in two themes. One is reconciliation, another one is prayer. Reconciliation and prayer, both are interlinked. They are always together. We cannot separate reconciliation and prayer. Now let us reflect why reconciliation and prayer are interlinked. What is reconciliation? Reconciliation means reunion, bringing together. What do we reunite, or what do we bring together? The answer is the final creation of God, that is human being. In reconciliation, we reunite one another. In reconciliation, we bring together one and the other. That's what we call a reconciliation. And in today's gospel, Jesus clearly speak about it. What is a sacrament of reconciliation? And Jesus speaks about three types of reconciliation. One is individual reconciliation, and the second is family reconciliation, third, community reconciliation. When we reunite a people, when we reunite or when we bring together a person in reconciliation, we become a messenger of God's reconciliation. Today's first reading speaks about that. St. Prophet Ezekiel was sent by God as a messenger of God's reconciliation. If the person listens to you, they will be saved. If they don't listen to you, they will die, whereas you will be saved. When we become a messenger of God's reconciliation, our life will be saved. Not only our lives, even we can save the lives of the other. That's what we read in today's first reading. In the gospel, Jesus speaks about three types of reconciliation: individual, family, and community. When we reflect about the individual reconciliation, there are three dimensions we could see. One is an individual to God, another one is individual to other, and third, individual within himself or herself. St. Luke clearly speaks about in his gospel, when a person commits sins, there are three relationships had been broken. A relationship between one and God, a relationship between one another, and a relationship within, an intrapersonal relationship. These three relationships had been broken. When a person is reconciled, he will experience a true happiness, a true peace of mind and heart. That's what St. Luke superly clearly speaks about in his gospel. So dear friends, when we think about individual reconciliation, when we commit sin, we feel guilty for the sins, and we regret that we commit sin against God, against other. When we feel regret, we need to reconcile with God. Whereas when we feel ego, or when we get angry, when we feel superiority over the other, when we try to control other, when we try to use others for our good, then we are sinners against in front of others. So we need to reconcile with the others. Whereas when we commit sin, there is no peace in our heart. Because of that, we feel guilty, we regret. Because of that, we are sad. And because of that emotions, we may feel sick. So we need to reconcile within ourselves. And when we come to the family reconciliation, most of us learn many things from our family life. We learn value, we learn what is faith, we learn what is love. Now let us reflect about today's situation. Family don't have time together. They don't spend a precious time together because everyone become workaholic. We all become machines, and we are always engaged, busy with social media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and we don't spend quality time with our family members. Thank God, lockdown has brought us back. It brought us what we lost, the true love in the family, the true intimacy in the family. Lockdown has brought back. So, what do we do in our family life? We need to regain the love. We need to regain the true intimacy that we have in our family life. So, the lockdown taught us clearly. So, we need to reconcile in the family. Finally, we speak about the community reconciliation. This is the last place where we need to be reconciled. And when we reconciled, then we will become a true human being, a true holy person in front of God. So in the community, there will be a leader who will guide. If he fails to bring a reconciliation, then Jesus clearly says, consider him as a Gentile. This is a severe punishment given to the person. And he feels lonely. He feels regret. He was set apart. He was put away from the community. That is a severe punishment Jesus speaks about in today's gospel. A final solution, only prayer can bring us a true reconciliation. That's what Jesus speaks in the Gospel of John, chapter 17, verse 21. Jesus himself prayed, Lord, that they all may become one. Jesus prayed for the unity, and he wants that unity. He wants that unity. That's why he completely sacrificed his life on the cross. By sacrificing his life on the cross, he brought a true reconciliation to the world, to the whole humanity. So when we have a problem in person, when we have a problem in the family, when we have a problem in the community, we can solve all those problems when a person prays, when a family prays, when a community prays, there will be reconciliation. So that's what Jesus in today's gospel clearly tells us. So let us pray for this particular grace. We need to bring a reconciliation within oneself. We need to bring reconciliation with God, and we need to bring reconciliation with one another. If it is not possible, it is possible only by God. So pray personally, pray as a family, pray as a community in the love of God, having faith in God, and he will work in us, he will work in our lives, and he will bring us a true reconciliation.
Let us pray for our Archdiocese, our Archbishop Peter, all the parish priests, assistants, religious priests working in the diocese, all the religious nuns who are working in the diocese, all the pious groups, lay ministers, and all those who work for the Word of God in our diocese. Let us pray for all the families, that they be united in peace and understanding, very particularly in the spirit of brotherhood, reconciliation, restoring unity among themselves in every family. Very particularly, we shall pray for those families who are broken, husbands and wives not in a cordial relationship, children not united with the parents, broken families because of infidelity, husband not faithful to the wife, wife not faithful to the husband. Let's pray for these families that the Lord is talking about. Reconciliation may be the hallmark of every family, very particularly Christian family. Let us pray for their unity and peace at home. Let us pray for each one of our lives, that we may restore our peace with one another, that this worship may become meaningful. Anyone having ill feelings against anyone, those who are in the church here today, that they may feel always reconciled, forgiven, forgiving, and respecting and loving one another. So that what the Lord says, where two or three gathered in my name praying, I am present. Let's pray and hope that the Lord is present here with us because we are praying together. And we make these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In bread we bring you, Lord, our bodies labor. In wine we offer you our spirits grieve. We do not ask you, Lord, who is my neighbor, but stand now, one in belief. Oh, we have gladly heard your word, your holy word, and now in answer, Lord, our gifts we
pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of all his holy church.
O God, O give us the gift of true prayer and of peace. Graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy,
Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence to minister to you.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, and Peter our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, the souls of Ammani Kochappan, Annamkutty Paulus, Anthony Chinnappa, Elizabeth Mary, Petronius Silveira, A.I. Nathan, Lourdes Mary, Agapitus, Lawrence, Susila, Chakku, and Arul Mary, Jenny Joseph, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in a mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. A mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her chaste spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Francis Xavier, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, so we have the courage to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ be to the last. Amen. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Santosh Kumar, daughter of Bilavendra Jacinta of our parish, marries Jayashree, daughter of Daniel and Anthony Mary of Darsani Palya parish. If at all you come across any problem regarding this marriage, you may bring it to my knowledge. Another bands. Eighth Tuesday, as usual, at 7 o'clock, we will have Grand Mass in honor of our Blessed Mary's Nativity. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.